How can I not cry? God, I wish I would have died. Sob Sabzwaray. Before dawn, on February 12th, five members of her family were killed as U.S. Special Forces stormed their home. A night that had started with celebrations to welcome the birth of a boy. Gulalai was 18 and engaged to be married. Salaha had 10 children and Bibi Shirin had 4. Both women were pregnant. Zohir was a local prosecutor. He left behind 7 children. And Dawood was a police commander who worked side by side with the Americans. He had 8 children, including 16-year-old Siddiqullah, who was shot twice but survived. This is the family's account of that night. At around 4 a.m. that cold February night, Commander Dawood went into the room where the party was taking place. It had just wound down, and he noticed that the light was turned off and not by them. That's when he noticed a red laser. When he came out to the courtyard right here, he noticed forces, U.S. forces on the rooftop. They shot him at this area. That's when his family members, the women, came running from different parts of the compound. They pulled him into that room with his brother, Muhammad Zohir. They went into that area, and the brother tried to come out, and he said in English to the U.S. forces, "Don't shoot at us. We're people of the government." The women were holding him back, saying, "You'll be shot too." And they were right, because they started shooting in that direction, and that's where they were killed. 2 were actually still alive, but not able to be taken to a hospital because the forces would not let the family leave the home. An elderly relative of the dead walks in and shows me a bullet he says was fired that night. Muhammad Sabir says he witnessed the deaths of his brothers, wife, sister, and niece. "She was squatting here, and I thought my sister fainted, but she was dead," he says. Shortly after the incident, NATO said a joint U.S.-Afghan force responding to intelligence about militant activity made a gruesome discovery that bound and gagged bodies of 3 women. It also said that several insurgents engaged the joint force in a firefight, but a month later admitted no one at the compound had opened fire. And this week, NATO agreed international forces were responsible for the deaths of the women. But now there are more damaging accusations. Hours after the shootings, Muhammad Sabir says he shot this cell phone video.
"I'm watching what's going on here.
You can hear American voices, the first investigators on the scene. Sabir claims soldiers on the raid dug bullets out of the bodies and then cleaned the wounds in an attempt to cover up. Afghan investigators won't comment on that claim, but tell CNN they have found evidence of a cover-up. NATO says it has discovered no evidence that any of our forces did anything to manipulate the evidence at the scene or the bodies. Its investigation continues. Thursday, a U.S. general offered his condolences to the family, calling the actions of that February night a mistake. And in Pashtun tradition, offered sheep and money as compensation. "I said no," Haji Sharafuddin says. "Give me the money your men took from us that night, and give me the spies who gave you the wrong family." A family that has lost 5 members because of bad information, and the sort of bungled operation that the U.S. military here is trying hard to avoid. Atiyah Abawi, CNN, Khataba Village in Paktia Province, Afghanistan.